Hello student, good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think we were discussing about the carbohydrate, basics of carbohydrate. In that we have learned some of the terms which are involved, such as enantiomers, diastereomers, epimers, mutar rotation, anomers. These are the terms and some of the reaction as well as objection of the structure of glucose. For open chain structure of the glucose, these are the point we have discussed yesterday. So today what we are going to discuss, see here, cyclic structure of glucose, because there is a objection for open chain structure of the glucose, and that's why what are the objection noted or recorded by the scientists why open chain structure is not possible, or what there are some of the objection. So what are those objection? Let us revise that some of the objection to the open chain structure of glucose. What are those objection mentioned by the different group of scientists regarding the open chain structure? First objection they recorded, they noted that glucose does not form bisulfite addition product with saturated solution of sodium bisulfite, because this is one of the characteristic reaction of the any addition reaction with the aldehyde. If that aldehyde is present in the glucose, it must react with the saturated solution of the sodium bisulfite, but addition reaction does not give, and therefore this is the first objection recorded by the regarding this open chain structure. And second objection they have recorded, or they have pointed out, that glucose does not give pink color with Schiff's reagent, or it does not form aldehyde ammonia derivative on treatment with ammonia. So this is the second objection they pointed out regarding as a open chain, because when suppose there is a aldehyde group is present, it must react with the Schiff reagent, and the result of that product is a pink color. That clearly indicate that the presence of aldehyde group in a unknown compound. So this is a one of the confirmatory test regarding the aldehyde group. So if pink color is observed, that the scientists come to know that there is an aldehyde group is present, but in a glucose does not produce, does not give pink color, and therefore it is a second objection pointed regarding that open chain structure of glucose. Another, in addition to that, when it is treated with ammonia, it does not give the ammonia derivative, and that is another objection mentioned regarding that open chain. And another objection, third objection mentioned over here, pentacetyl glucose does not react with hydroxylamine. Hydroxylamine, when it react with aldehyde, it gives the oxime derivatives. But if you treat the pentacetyl derivatives of glucose with phenylhydrazine, it does not produce, it does not give the oxime as a derivative, and therefore this is also as a objection pointed out or mentioned by the regarding that open chain compound. Then the fourth one, generally aldehyde react with two moles of alcohols and form acetyl derivative. If the glucose containing as a aldehyde group, it must consume 2 moles of the alcohol and gives the acetyl derivatives, but this glucose does not consume 2 moles of alcohol. Instead, it consume only as a 1 mole of the alcohol and gives the hemiacetal derivatives or hemiacetal type of the product. So this is the objectional point regarding that open chain. In addition to these objections, one more objection pointed or mentioned by those scientists, glucose exhibit the phenomenon of mutarotation, which is a characteristic of ring compound. Mutarotation, as we know that yesterday, mutarotation. So that is the characteristic of the ring compound, and therefore there is a possibility of that glucose, it may present in the ring form. How it is going to form as a cyclic structure, then before that we have seen as a hemiacetal, some of the reaction of that glucose also we have studied in detail. So now today we are going to discuss about the cyclic structure of glucose. Let's see, or what we can call it as a ring formation. It is a ring formation. So that is the thing we are discussing right now, cyclic structure of glucose or ring formation. Now, starting from open chain structure of D-glucose, the ring formation occurs as follows. As we know that according to the Fischer projection formula, we know that how to write that structure of the glucose. So by using that structure, we can form as a cyclic ring of glucose. And let us see point to point, step by step, how we are going to form the ring that we are going to learn. Let us see point number one, simple rotation of the bond between C4 and C5 of the coiled structure of glucose takes place in an anticlockwise direction, so that the C5OH group moves into position for reaction with CHO group, that is a C1 group. As we know that the structure of glucose according to as a Fisher projection formula or in a coiled structure you can write, and then rotate the groove in a such a way that the rotation should be anti-clockwise manner. So when you rotate the plane of polar, you rotate the groove in a anti-clockwise manner, the hydroxy group at C5 position are in a position to attack to the reaction center of carbonyl carbon of aldehyde group. So, and that's why they have rotated the groove in a anti-clockwise manner. So that is the reason why they are rotating the groove in a anti-clockwise manner, so that the OH group becomes as a come in a proper position to attack to the reaction center of carbonyl carbon. That's the first point they have mentioned over here. Now let us see the second point. After this reaction, the CH2OH group means primary alcohol group C6 occupies the position that was previously occupied in coiled structure by hydrogen at C5. They exchange the position, that CH2OH group primary alcohol take the position of hydrogen atom, and hydrogen atom goes on the position of that. They are exchanging their position, or they are exchanging the position of each other. So that's the matter of concern over here. Now let us see the third point regarding that ring formation. Now the C5OH group attacks at C1, as we know that the groove of aldehyde, and as you know that aldehyde group is always present at the end of the carbon chain, and it is considered whenever the number is given, the numbering should be starting from most oxidizable, the oxidizable group, and therefore carbonyl carbon is a oxidizable group, that aldehyde group, and therefore aldehyde group always given the number 1. So that is the general guideline or a general way of numbering. So now the C5OH group attach at C1 and form a hemiacetal ring, so that the C1 becomes a new asymmetric carbon atom. Asymmetric carbon atom, or the alternative name of that carbon, is a chiral center. And therefore, two stereoisomers are possible. Stereoisomer means they are the optical isomers. These are alpha and beta form of glucose. Alpha and beta, shortly we are going to see that one. These are alpha and beta form of glucose, they are known as epimers, epimers in bracket anomers. I already explained, we already discussed these two terms, epimers and the anomers, right? Epimers and anomers, they are similar words, or what we can call it as a term, which are used in the carbohydrate chemistry. Epimers is a very simple, the suitable example are D-glucose and D-mannose, or D-glucose and D-galactose. So epimer means what? The optical isomers differ in configuration at only one carbon atom is known as epimers of each other. And anomers are, it is related to as a cyclic structure of cyclic structures, and where there is a mutarotation, and mutarotation, the optical rotation changes spontaneously, and we are getting as a diastereomers, such a pair of diastereomers are known as anomers. For example, alpha D glucose and beta D glucose are anomers of each other, means this type of the diastereomers are known as anomers, that we already discussed over here, but I again told about that this. And these are alpha beta form of glucose, and they are known as epimers, means anomers, because they differ only in the configuration at the hemiacetal carbon C1. Remember, hemiacetal carbon means carbon number one. In a one case, in a one structure, the hydroxy group, OH group, are on the above side, that is termed as a beta side. And when that hydroxy group are below the plane, then we can call it as a alpha side. And therefore, these alpha and beta side, they are diastereomers of each other. That C1 carbon atom, other, and when the ring is formed, that we are going to see shortly. Before that, when the ring is formed in an open chain, as we know that glucose has four chiral centers. When the ring is formed, then glucose one chiral center is increased, additional one carbon atom. Therefore, in a cyclic form, when the glucose form as a cyclic structure, and then there will be a 5 chiral center, and when that becomes as a 5 chiral center, then a cyclic form of D-glucose have 5 asymmetric carbon atom. And asymmetric carbon atom, just now we mentioned that asymmetric carbon atom means carbon atom carrying 4 different group are known as asymmetric carbon atom, or the alternative name of this term, alternative word for this asymmetric carbon atom, we can call it as a chiral center. Chiral center and the asymmetric carbon, one and the same thing, and the definition also as the same. The carbon atom carrying 4 different group are known as a chiral center, and chiral center, if it is present there, and then that compound may be the optically active in nature. Optically activity is the experimental quantity, so that we know that, and when hence there are 2^n, according to as a Hondsoff rule, we know that 2^n is equal to 2^5 is equal to 32 optical isomers containing 16 pair of enantiomers. Enantiomer, as we know that, the optical isomers which are non-superimposable mirror images of each other are known as enantiomers. they have same properties, melting point, boiling point, physical properties, chemical properties, everything is the same, only they differ in the configuration. One rotates the plane of polarization through left hand side, whereas another rotates the plane of polarization to the right hand side. Only optical rotation are different, so that type of the compound are enantiomers of each other, that we know that. Now let us see how the glucose that compound is formed. Let us see the structure of glucose. As you know that the structure of glucose is this one. Generally we are writing this structure CHO, then 1, 2, 3, 4, and then here is a CH2OH. That is a general way of representing the open chain glucose structure according to as a Fischer projection formula. Here H, HO, and here H and OH. If you number, and as we know that number are given to this skeleton, this framework is like this: aldehyde 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? At a carbon number 1 that having as aldehyde group, whereas 2, 3, 4, and 5 is shown by star, they are the chiral centers. Now this structure we can draw in a coil structure form. So this structure we can draw like this in a coil structure of this. There this is a carbon oxygen double bond, here hydrogen atom, aldehyde group I am putting over here one, and then rest of the here, this is a carbon I am showing over here, and above here this is a structure that becomes here CH2OH, above one is a H, below one is a OH, and rest of the when OH on a right hand side they goes below the plane here like this, and those groove on a left hand side they goes above the plane here. It is OH, look at here, is below the plane, and there right hand side that goes below the plane. At this position, 5 position, this carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, right? Now this is a coiled structure of glucose. This is a coiled structure of glucose. This is a D glucose, open chain structure, glucose, glucose. This is a D glucose. Now this is a coiled structure of glucose. Now if you see over here, if you observe this structure carefully, now rotate between C4, C5 rotation. Rotation, what type of the rotation it is? You can do the rotation anti-clockwise manner. Anti-clockwise manner means what? This bond is rotating like this, this bond is rotating like this, and this bond is rotating like this. So why we are rotating as an anti-clockwise manner? Because here at carbon number 5, the hydroxy group you have to bring in a such a way that bring in a position so that it can attack to the reaction center of that carbonyl carbon, and that's why we are rotating the group in a anti-clockwise manner. After rotating, what you are going to get over here? Another thing you have to write down as it is, your C double bond O is a hydrogen atom, or you can show this somewhat, they are above the plane like this. So that is a group you can show over here. Here this carbon atom, now when after rotating as anti-clockwise, this CH2OH group goes at the top, this hydrogen atom comes here, and this hydroxy group suitably goes there, and rest of the thing it remains as it is. As we know that this is the here, those group on a right hand side, they goes below the plane, those are on a left hand side, those goes above the plane, and here hydroxy group that is below the plane, rest of the thing remains as it is. And after that, what is going to happen? This is a lone pair which is present on oxygen atom. They are suitably attacking to the carbonyl carbon, which is a reaction center, and this is the way you are going to get that compound. And there are two possibilities of this attack. Now let me show this structure once again here, so that you can properly see this one. Here this is a carbon atom, OH I am putting over here, CH2 I am not doing anything new, only this structure I am drawing as it is over here like this. C double bond O, this is the hydrogen atom. Now this structure as it is, only here this one is the OH, this OH, and this will be the H, right? This is the way, and this hydrogen atom. Now with this lone pair suitably attack on that carbonyl group, there are the two possibilities. One possibility, when ring is formed, that OH goes above the plane. So this pyranose ring is formed like this, this ring, and where the hydroxy atom goes above the plane, and rest of the thing here, OH remains below the plane. Here OH should be above the plane, here hydroxy group should be below the plane. Now this one, this remains as it is, this one CH2OH like this. And now this is the carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there are 5 chiral center. Look at here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 5 carbon center, chiral centers are there. This is known as the open form of D glucose. This is known as a open form of D glucose. D glucose, open form of the D glucose, and it shows the specific rotation, specific rotation found to be 52.5 degree. That is the characteristic of that open form of D glucose. And now when we are getting this structure, this is a beta side, we can call it. It is a beta D glucose, beta D plus glucose
glucose,
and which has a specific rotation is observed. Specific rotation observed is equal to plus 19 degree. This is a specific rotation observed when this form is formed. And now on this side we can show another ring. You may get here, let me draw properly here. The structure is this one, and now the hydroxy group should be below the plane now, and here this hydroxy group OH below the plane, this one above the plane, below the plane, and this CH2OH, this one is called as a alpha side, and therefore the name of this structure is known as alpha D plus glucose, and the specific rotation observed is plus 113 degree. Look at here, specific rotation specifically or purposely I am showing over here. When at an equilibrium the specific rotation reaches a constant value is 52.5 degree centigrade. When the ring formation, these two structures are known as, they are anomers of each other. Anomers means here this is a carbon number 1, and carbon number 1 hydroxy group are above the plane. Here the hydroxy group is below the plane. This is the alpha side, that one is the beta side. Only they differ in a configuration at only one carbon atom. Such a type of the this alpha D glucose and beta D glucose are anomers of each other. Remember, this is the best example of anomer while studying, while mentioning, while answering that anomers means what. This is the best example of that anomer. Epimer we are considering as a open chain compound. So open chain compound, there we have seen two pairs mainly. One is a D glucose and D mannose, D glucose and D galactose. They are the suitable example for what we can call it as a epimers, and these are the enomers, anomers. Anomers means what? They are showing as a specific rotation, and that specific rotation observed here is 52.5 degree centigrade. When the it is naturally occurring that glucose having as a melting point is 146 degree centigrade, and it after continuous change in spontaneous change in a specific rotation and reaches a constant value is 52.5 degree centigrade, and that phenomenon is known as a muta rotation. That also we have learned in this particular case. So this is what we have seen so far. This all about the cyclic structure of the glucose. Now here the representation of ring structure, that is a Haworth formula, whatever we have seen. So this type of the structure is explained by the another scientist. Whatever we have seen so far all about the Fischer projection formula, some of the time we are talking about the stick and ball formula or perspective formula. Now is a representation of a ring structure. There is a Haworth formula is one of the what we can call it as the best way to represent to show the ring structure is well studied by the scientist. The name of that scientist is a Haworth formula. It is more convenient to represent the ring structure of D glucose in Haworth projection formulae, and the English chemist W.H. Haworth W.H. Howard proposed that the first five carbon atom of the aldohexoses and oxygen atom of the ring might better be represented as a hexagonal ring in the plane perpendicular to the plane of the paper. So these are the sum of the prediction he recorded or he mentioned over here. And first one, from the Fisher projection formula, the group lying on the left side, left are taken above, and the group lying on the right are taken below the horizontal ring. So that is the conclusion, or that is the main thing is recorded over here. When they look at here the hydroxy group in a Fisher projection formula, the general way of writing that Fisher projection formula, so remember here hydroxy group is present on the right hand side. Those group present on the right hand side in the Fisher projection formula, when we convert into as a Haworth projection formula, that hydroxy group goes below the plane, whereas those hydroxy group in a Fisher projection formula present on a right, present on a left hand side. When you are writing according to as a Haworth projection formula, that goes above the plane, or we must show the group above the plane, that hydroxy group must be above the plane. So that are the general way of showing or converting Fisher projection formula and the Haworth projection formula. The side of the hexagon that is closer to the observer is shown by a thicker line. So that are the some general guidelines are given. So I think representation of the ring structure of Haworth projection formula, that we will discuss tomorrow. Let us stop today here. Thank you. Have a nice day.